Imagine you find a house that you really like and you want to know how much you should pay to make that house yours. Or you might want to know what is your current house worth in the market. In this video, I'm going to give you three simple steps that anyone can follow to find market value of a house. Sounds too simple? It actually is. Just follow along with me. I am confident you will be convinced. Hello everyone, I am Ajinkya Patil and welcome to my channel. In this series, Buying a House in the Netherlands, I am going to answer some of your most difficult questions when it comes to buying a house in the Netherlands. For example, should you buy a house now or should you wait until the market crashes? Or how do you find a good neighborhood? Now, buying a house is no easy task. There is no one place where you can find all the information that you need. My goal in this series is to make all the required information easily accessible to you so that you can make a well-informed decision about buying a house in the Netherlands. If you find this video useful, then hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. Also, in the comments below, let me know if you have any suggestions. Without further ado, let's get started. What is the market value of a house? Now, that is a million-dollar question. Maybe more like 10,000 euro question, but it is an important one. Because when you want to bid for a house, you want to bid high enough to actually win that bid, but also not too much more than what the house is actually worth. As promised, I'm going to give you three simple steps that you can follow to determine market value of any house. In each of these steps, we are going to make that estimate of the market value more and more accurate. So make sure you watch till the end to know the whole process and get a good and accurate market value of a house. At the end of this video, I'm also going to suggest how you can combine this three-step method with CalCasa. If you don't know what CalCasa is, don't worry. I'm going to explain in a few minutes. So let's get started. Step number one, finding the general market value of a house from Cadastre. If you are looking for a house in the Netherlands, you are most likely browsing through funda.nl. Many people assume that the asking prices that you see on Funda are also actually the general market values of those houses. But I'm sorry to tell you that an asking price of a house might be far away from a real market value. Now see, every real estate agent that is selling a house has a motive behind setting that asking price. Some might set the price higher than the market price, and in that way, make you think it is more worth than what it is, or some might actually set it lower. And in that way, they might get more and more people interested in the property and make them compete against each other to drive the prices even higher. So what about using some actual data to determine the market value of a house? What I'm talking about is actual data of selling prices of very similar properties in the same neighborhood. Now you might think, where can I find such an information? The magic answer is Cadastre. Cadastre is the service or land registry in the Netherlands. So they have the records of selling prices of each and every house that is sold in the market. And good for us that all that information is actually public. Let me show you how you can get this information. Go to cadastre.nl, type in the address of the house you are interested in, scroll down and select Koopsom Informatie. Note, we don't want the first option, but rather Koopsom Informatie. Scroll down again and click on New Bestellen. You will see a pop-up that for a small price of €2.95, you can get a report of house prices in that street. Let's take one example. I was interested in a particular house towards the end of 2019. The house was listed for 290,000 euros. I went to Cadastre and got this report of selling prices of similar properties in the same street. From this report, we can see that there are three properties that were sold in that year and roughly for 275,000 euros. From this report, we can conclude that the general market value of such a house was about 275,000 euros towards the middle of 2019.
One tip, sometimes there are similar properties not only in the same street but also in neighboring streets or in the same neighborhood. Now, Cadastre gives us information only about that street. So go on Funda and look for map view, and if you see similar properties on other streets, get market information from Cadastre also for those houses. Concluding step one, what we saw is that we can get real market information from Cadastre. In this example of a house that was listed for 290,000 euros, we saw that 6 months ago, very similar properties were sold for 275,000 euros. Now remember, in the next step, we are going to make this market value estimate more and more accurate. But for now, this is good enough. Let's go to step two. Step two, correct for the most recent trends in the market. Now you might ask, after step one, I already got the market information of the house. So why do I need step two? Now you see, unfortunately, Cadastre may not be able to give us information about properties that were sold in last couple of months. Now why? There might be a few months time period between a buyer buys a house and actually goes to a notary to get it transferred on his or her name. Because that time period might be used to get a mortgage, sell your current house, and so on. And Cadastre knows about selling price only after you go to a notary. That is why from step one, we cannot get the most recent trends in the market. So in this step, what we are going to do is we are going to correct for the most recent trends in the market in the last couple of months. Again, the information about most recent trends in the market is also public. We are going to use the reports from Central Bureau of Statistics.
Every month, the CBS or the Central Bureau for Statistics reports the most recent trends in housing prices. I'm going to leave this link below in the description. For example, in January 2021, the house prices in Netherlands had an annual growth rate of 9%. You can click on the article to get more details. The CBS also publishes numbers for specific regions. So, for example, you can find out in North Brabant region, the house prices went up by 8.8%. I will also leave this link below in the description.
Let's say from the CBS reports, we found out that the annual growth rate of house prices has been 9%. And the latest properties that we found in our Cadastre report from step one were sold 6 months ago, then we have to correct, let's say, half of that 9%, 4.5% as a correction for the last 6 months. Now let's go back to our example of the house that was listed for 290,000 in December of 2019. In step one, from Cadastre reports, we found out that similar properties were sold for 275,000 about 6 months ago. And from CBS reports, towards the end of 2019, I can see that the house prices were going up by about 5.8% a year. Correcting for half of that for half of the year, the new estimate for the market value of this house comes to 282,000 euros. Concluding step two, what we have now done is we started with the general market value of a house in step one, and we corrected for the most recent trends in the market to get a refined estimate of the market value of a house. In step three, we are going to make it even more accurate. Step three, customize the market valuation for a given house. Now you see, houses that are in the same street might be similar, but they are not identical to the house you are interested in. The particular house might have better maintenance or
an extended construction, or maybe just a recently renovated bathroom or kitchen. In this step, we are going to account for each of these unique properties of that house to get our market value even more refined and accurate. In this step, what I want you to do is to list down all the differences that you can find between the house that you want to buy and the similar properties you found on Cadastre. Once we have listed down all these differences, we are going to fill in what it typically costs to make such a change in a house. Here in this table, I am giving you a few examples of differences you might find and how much they cost typically. Going back to our example house, the only difference it had from other properties in the cadastre report was that this was a middle row house, whereas the other houses were corner houses. Many people might be willing to pay a few thousand euros extra for a corner house because it offers extra privacy. Therefore, for our example house, because it's not a corner house, we are going to subtract about 5,000 euros from our estimate of step 2 of 282,000. Our final valuation of this house comes to be 277,000 euros, much lower than 290,000 euros as the list price. This example shows that there could be houses that are listed at prices higher than their market value. Even in a market where many houses are being sold at much higher price than their list prices. Now, I hope you found this method useful, where in step 1, we found the general market value of a house from Cadastre. In step 2, we revised it for the most recent trends in the market. And in step 3, we made it even more refined and customized to the house, accounting for all the little differences that it has from surrounding properties. Now, if you don't want to do all these three steps by yourself, there is an alternative. It's called Calcasa. Calcasa is an online valuation service. It uses an automated statistical model. What it does is it looks at 25 similar properties and corrects for recent trends in the market and also does some customization. Go to online.calcasa.nl, scroll down, and fill in the details of the house that you are interested in, such as the address of the house, when it was built, and the size of the house. This service costs €27.95. This is an example valuation report from Calcasa. You will see the market value of a house that you might be interested in. You will also see the list of reference properties from which the market value was determined. My suggestion would be to combine the best of both worlds. For example, you could replace the first two steps in our three-step valuation method by Calcasa. That way, you can get even more accurate general market value and corrections from the recent market trends from Calcasa. And then, since you have visited the house, you would know what are the unique properties of the house, such as a recent innovation of the kitchen, and try to customize the house in step 3 to get the most accurate valuation. I hope you liked this video and found it useful. Hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and press on the bell icon so that you can get notifications about my next videos. Also, in the comments below, let me know if you have any suggestions.